Hi, I'm Scott Walker. Thanks for joining us for another episode of Freedom Fighters. August 31st came and went, and sadly, Americans are still stranded in Afghanistan. A couple weeks ago on August 18th, Joe Biden said during an interview with ABC News' George Stephanopoulos that the United States is committed to getting every American out of Afghanistan, even if it means potentially extending the military mission beyond the August 31st deadline. Now, pressed by Stephanopoulos about what would happen if all of our citizens were not safely out of Afghanistan by the deadline, Joe Biden said, quote, "If there's American citizens left, we're going to stay to get them all out," unquote. Joe Biden lied. He flat out lied. This artificial deadline had already been moved. The Biden administration was under no legal requirement to withdraw by the end of August. This didn't have to end this way. Pentagon spokesman John Kirby said this week that we certainly would have liked and preferred to get more people out if we could, but the time just wasn't there. That's BS. We have the greatest fighting force in the history of the world. The men and women of the United States Armed Forces could have easily evacuated every single American. For that matter, they could have got out all the Afghans who helped our military personnel over the past 20 years. This was not a failure of the military. Let me repeat that. This was not a failure of the military. This was a failure of its civilian leadership. And the buck stops firmly with Joe Biden, who's supposed to be acting as the commander-in-chief, not the commander of chaos and incompetence. You see, there's no law that says American troops had to be out by August 31st, 2021. The deadline had already been moved in the past. So what is more important? Meeting a randomly selected deadline or rescuing American citizens and our allies? Only a traitor would have picked a meaningless deadline. Traitor Joe and the Biden betrayal. I don't use these terms lightly, but someone criticized me for calling the president a traitor. But the definition of traitor is, quote, "a person who betrays a friend, country, principle, etc." unquote. The example given actually says, quote, "they see me as a traitor, a sellout to the enemy," unquote. Well, Joe Biden betrayed our friends by not telling our allies what was going on in advance of the withdrawal and by not evacuating all the Afghans who had supported our troops in advance of the withdrawal. Ironically, one of the people left behind is an Afghan interpreter who actually helped in the 2008 rescue of, get this, then United States Senator Joe Biden and two other members of the Senate from a valley in Afghanistan. This guy had been trying to escape from Afghanistan for years. On Tuesday, he had a simple message for the man he helped save. "Hello, Mr. President, save me and my family. Don't forget me." Sadly, Joe Biden has betrayed him too. You see, Joe Biden betrayed our country by turning Afghanistan over to the Taliban before our citizens, our troops, and our allies were safely out of the country. His disastrous withdrawal needlessly put members of our armed forces in harm's way. And tragically, that opened the door to the terrorist attacks that just killed 13 service members. Today, Taliban and other terrorists now have control over billions and billions of dollars worth of our weapons and equipment from the U.S. Armed Forces. Not only did the Biden administration abandon these things, they literally failed to destroy them, and now they could actually end up being used against us and our allies. Joe Biden betrayed the principles of our armed forces. The U.S. military has a very sacred commitment to leave no one behind. For example, the Airman's Creed says, "I will never leave an airman behind." The Soldier's Creed says, "I will never leave a fallen comrade." Pulling out of Kabul on Tuesday night without taking all the remaining citizens, well, that's a complete betrayal. The last several planes weren't even filled with our American citizens. Because the Biden betrayal included turning over perimeter security to the Taliban, many of those citizens were not even able to reach the airport in time. Tragically, many of them will likely be hunted down, tortured, or even killed. Joe Biden betrayed our friends, our country, and our principles. Sadly, that's the definition of a traitor. He seems to be more concerned about saying the war ended by August 31st than in actually saying he was going to save every American. As much as many people wanted the United States to get out of Afghanistan, I firmly believe they did not want to do it at the expense of the lives of fellow American citizens. It did not have to end this way. Joe Biden has failed us. Now is the time for Democrats and Republicans to push back. Members of Congress from both parties are rightly concerned about this disaster. They need to continue to speak out, and they need to take action. The future of our country is dependent on it. I'm Scott Walker. Thanks for listening. Until next time, keep fighting for freedom.